we thank you, Lord, that we can come to your presence. Lord, and lift up holy hands to be Jehovah, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Father, you are lifted, my God, this very day. Father, we say there is none like you, my God. You that make it the way when it seems to be no way. You that came without prophecy and accepted the light. The God of Abraham, the God of Moses. Father, we exalt you this very morning. We say, mighty Jehovah, may you arise and let your enemies scatter, my God. In the mighty name of Jesus, let there be a testimony, my Father. Be lifted, Father, and be glorified, my Jesus. We honor you, mighty Jehovah. We thank you, Spirit of the living God, that without you we have no way to go. We thank you, Lord, that when you left, you said, I will send you a helper, who is the Holy Spirit, to guide and to lead you to direct. We are thankful, my Father God, this very day, that we are never left alone. Father, we are blessed, my God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We lay it all, my Father God, before you this very morning. My Father, we say, take control and take over. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you, Spirit of the living God. We worship, my God. We worship. We worship, Lord. We bless your name, Spirit of the living God. We thank you, mighty Jehovah. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Something that the Lord is doing in our prayer garden. Amen. Just a word, somebody requested that we share that this beautiful word this morning. Hallelujah. Say, in our prayer then, our theme is this morning, supernatural breakthrough. Taken from the book of Zechariah chapter 1, verse 18 to 20. If you are there, say amen. Then I looked up, and there before me were four horns. I asked the angel who was speaking to me, what are these? He answered me, these are the horns that scatter Judah, Israel, and Jerusalem. Our last verse, verse 20. Then the Lord showed me four craftsmen. Amen. May God bless the reading of his word this morning. Amen. What are these four winds or horns I'm speaking about? Often, horns signify the power of princesses and people. The metaphor being taken from those cattle whose strength lies in their horns. Meaning, the horns here mentioned donate the powers which had scattered Israel and Judah, or that should scatter them, as a bull in his fury tosses into the air whatever opposes him. Maybe as I speak to you in this prayer garden this morning, you might be surrounded by enemies. Here we see the enemies of the house of Israel being threatened, threatening the church to cut off the name of Israel out of the earth. There are horns which have got emblems of power, strength, and violence. Maybe as I come and talk to you this morning, you might be looking at your situation. Your enemies would have been in a position of taking up what seems that you can no longer fight back. There's been violence. You have lost great things. When the prophet saw this and saw these horns, he began to despair of the safety of every good man and the success of every good work. When we go through attacks, when our enemies have power over our lives, we feel we have lost it all. There is a fear. We feel we are no longer going to succeed. We feel there is no more help. But as
as the prophet was looking at that, he saw four crushed men. The Lord showed him to say, when there was no hope, here appears four craftsmen. What is the representation of these four craftsmen? They were empowered to cut off these horns. Hallelujah. No matter what you are going through, the Lord has prepared a craftsman to cut off your problem. Hallelujah. I would love you to open your eye of faith and see your God in action with the eye of flesh. We see our enemies overpowering us. We carry all the negative things that the enemy is giving us. If you open your spiritual eyes, no matter how the world looks at you, they judge you, they say about you, with the eye of faith, you are going to now begin to understand, maybe at this moment, that you are actually safe. Whatever that is meant to kill you can no longer kill you, but it is the power through God. There is somebody that God has appointed in your situation. As He has appointed somebody to come and help you wherever you are. I am here standing as an apostle of the word of God, sent of the Spirit of God to come and encourage you. When you feel you don't have hope, that there is hope. The Bible says, my Bible teaches me this, that there is hope for a living dog than a dead lion. No matter how mighty the lion was when it is dead, there is no hope. But that dog that is walking around and roaming around, it still has hope. You can look at your condition and say, there is no hope anymore in my life. My enemies have surrounded me. Who can help me? I am carrying a negative report, but our God will surely come through for you. I believe this thing, that when God has work to do, He's going to raise somebody. I am saying to you, God is not yet finished with you. God is going to raise somebody, because for every Red Sea, there is going to be a Moses. For every Goliath that is going to cause havoc over you, there will be a David. And I want to say to you this morning, that in whatever situation you are going through, you shall be victor. There is you in that situation. You are not dead yet in that situation. You will come alive in that situation. The Lord is going to turn you around. So in this prayer garden this morning, I want to encourage you to say, God defends the defenseless. Amen. Hallelujah. So you need to carry this word through. This gives us the reason for us to open our eyes and look towards heaven. That is where our help is coming from. The Holy Spirit, the internal Spirit of God, who cares so much for us, even when people have abandoned us, situations have challenged us, we feel we don't have hope, the Spirit of God will never leave you, will never forsake you. And that is why I want to say to you, it is not over until the Lord says it's over. Open the eyes of faith. That is why Hebrews chapter 11 verse 1 says, now faith is being sure of what we hope for and certain of what we do not see. Your situation that you see is not your tomorrow. Your situation that you see, it will give up. The Lord will take you out of your condition. Hallelujah. And I want to pray with you and prophesy over your life and say this. As we come into this scripture confession, in Zechariah chapter 1 verse 17, the Bible says, cry yet, saying, thus saith the Lord of hosts, my city's true prosperity shall yet be spread. The Lord shall come forth Zion and shall yet choose Jerusalem. I am releasing a prophetic declaration over your life. And I want to say to you, whatever you are going through, this should be your cry this morning. That the Lord of hosts will still come forth for you and will cause you to prosper. If maybe you are sick and listening to this morning, there is still healing that is about to come. Whatever you are going through, It is not, your enemies would have concluded. Some people would have already prepared your obituary. But listen to me, you shall not die. The Lord still has a purpose for you. Maybe you are looking for a job. And you are saying, I've been looking for a job for years. There is craftsmen that are working your matter. There are people that the Lord is preparing to pull you through. So I am decreeing over your life this morning, and I want you to believe with me in these prophetic declarations. I want to say to you, your breakthrough starts now in the name of Jesus. Amen. May the Father, Lord, the Almighty God, by the power of the blood of Jesus and the fire of the Holy Ghost, scatter and destroy any hidden spirit that is around you. I want to say to you, let the Father, Lord, scatter and destroy the power of devouring spirit and limitation in your life. I want to say to you, any decree upon your feet, because you have come to Christ, as you are coming to Christ right now, I want to believe. Let it be revoked in the name of Jesus. And I want to say from today, let your feet be anointed and be washed in the blood of Jesus to lead you into peaceful places. I also want to decree over your life that let the Father, Lord, release the spirit of a carpenter upon your life and destroy every one of the enemy. Maybe it is witchcraft. Maybe it is your enemies that have bent up against you. Let the spirit of a carpenter arise over you. Let the spirit of God destroy it right now. And let him begin to paddle pit and make your matter to suit where you are going in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree to any cause satanic, anything that can cause satanic roadblock in your way to your breakthrough, let it fall down and be scattered and die in the mighty name of Jesus. And every satanic and collective power that wants to scatter what you have gathered, I command it to fall down in the name of Jesus and die. Any association of evil came up, or witchcraft power to cause derailment in your life, let it also be scattered in the name of Jesus. Any power that has been put in place to supervise, confirm failure in your life, let it die. I want to say to you, you are no longer going to fail. You will succeed where others said you are going to fail. You are the head and you are not the tail. Anything around you, anything within you, contesting with the presence of the Holy Spirit in you, I am saying to that thing, what are you still waiting for? Name of Jesus. Die forever. You know, there are certain spirits that have vowed they will never let you go until they die. I am here as an apostle and I'm saying to that spirit, die. Because I am releasing the blessed and effective God in the mighty name of Jesus. And I pray over you, Spirit of the living God, let it arise. Take you to a place where you never dreamt you are going to be. Let the beginning, after hearing what I'm saying right now, may you walk to your financial prosperity. May you walk to a land where there is no lack. Joshua, in the book of Joshua, the Bible says, every land you set your foot upon, you shall possess. I am decreeing this in this prophetic garden this morning, to say wherever you step your foot upon, wherever you are, you are healed in the mighty name of Jesus. I want us to pray. I want to pray with you. I want to release this with you. To say, it is your season of greatness. Whatever report that the enemy has said, I want you to receive these prophetic declarations. I want you to believe that even when Israel was being threatened, Judah was being threatened, the Lord yet comes there. There is somebody working on your matter, the Holy Spirit. He has been given to you as a comforter. He's saving you. Your relatives can forsake you. Your friends can forsake you. But listen to me, the Holy Spirit is watching over you. Our God that we serve does not sleep nor slumber. He knows about your need. Hallelujah. Stop crying. begin to praise God wherever you are. Let us pray. Father Lord, whatever weapons and things of the enemy to steal, kill and destroy, whatever they are going through, Jesus has already paid the price. Thank you, Lord. You have given us victory in Jesus' mighty name. Now and forever, in Jesus' mighty name. God bless you and amen. Hallelujah. Let's pray for Jesus. Let's pray for Jesus. It is done in the mighty name of Jesus. It is done in the mighty name of Jesus. May you succeed. Maybe somebody said to you, you are not going to get a job. I'm saying you are going to get that job in the name of Jesus. Maybe the doctor said you are going to die. They are not gods. You are going to live and declare the works of the Lord in the name of the living. I don't know what you are trusting God for. Is it a car? Is it a house? Is it a marriage? The Lord has already put over it into your life. May you receive it in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's have the worship team leading us in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
My heart, I worship you.